Now we'll continue with reactions of ammonium hydroxide using copper salts. Copper salts will react with ammonium hydroxide to form a pale blue precipitate of copper hydroxide. In this case, it is soluble in excess. Now, if you remember in the earlier sessions, we have seen reactions with sodium hydroxide. In that, with copper salts, it was a pale blue precipitate but insoluble in excess. So, you have to remember by comparison with NaOH, it is insoluble. And with ammonium hydroxide, it is soluble. Now, since it is soluble, you are having two equations here. The products of these equations, that is ammonium sulfate and copper hydroxide. In the same, you are adding excess of ammonium hydroxide. So, you are just writing the products here, copper hydroxide plus ammonium sulfate. And since you are using excess ammonium hydroxide, same 2NH4OH excess. Now here you are getting a complex. This is a complex salt, that is tetraamine copper sulfate complex, and the color of this complex is deep blue or inky blue, and it is a soluble complex. So because it is a soluble complex, this precipitate dissolves and you will get a clear solution which is deep blue or inky blue in color. Now if you observe the textbook or the PDF which will be subsequently given to you, there are two equations in this. Now in the second equation, only the precipitate reaction is shown. Yes. Now this particular reaction is formation of the precipitate. Now in this test tube, see, in one test tube you are adding copper sulfate, to the same test tube you are adding ammonium hydroxide, and you are getting in that same test tube copper hydroxide and ammonium sulfate. Now ammonium sulfate is soluble, so it will be a supernatant. Now, if you pour that supernatant means the liquid above. So if you pour out that supernatant and take only the precipitate, which is copper hydroxide. So in that copper hydroxide, now you have to add excess of ammonium hydroxide. Then you will get again a complex salt, which is tetraamine copper hydroxide complex. Again, color of this is deep blue or inky blue. So either you can write this particular reaction when it is asked for excess, or you can write this particular reaction. You can remember any of the reactions. But in your textbook and in the PDF, both the reactions are explained. So you have to understand the difference between the two reactions. In the first, complex is tetraamine copper to sulfate. Why? Because we are taking the products of the earlier reaction, and in that we are adding excess of ammonium hydroxide. And in the second, only the precipitate is reacting with excess of ammonium hydroxide. So our complex is becoming just tetraamine copper hydroxide. And here the complex is tetraamine copper sulfate. So you understand the difference and the reactions. And remembering the reaction is also very simple. What is the trick? First reaction is easy to understand. It's a double decomposition reaction. You know the valencies of the radicals. So you will balance it in the same manner. So you just take products of first reaction and in that excess of NH4OH. And this is what you are supposed to remember. Tetraamine. Tetra means 4. So 4 times amine. Amine is amino group NH3. So 4 times NH3 copper sulfate. This is how you are going to write it. Plus 4 molecules of water. So many times children make mistakes in this reaction. So this is the trick and how you are supposed to remember it. Okay. And the second, if you want to remember the second reaction, no problem. So just take the precipitate in that excess of NH4OH and tetraamine. Tetra is 4, NH3 copper hydroxide. Since copper valency is 2, OH becomes twice here. Copper and sulfate, both valencies plus 2 and minus 2. So there is no 2. Okay. So this is reaction with copper salts. Now you have to remember that this particular reaction, it is a 5-star reaction. Why? Because a lot of questions are asked based on this reaction. In the sense, state your observations either in a small, when copper sulfate is added to ammonium hydroxide, first in a small quantity and then in excess. So if it is asked in that manner, then you have to explain the excess part also, that is pale blue precipitate turning to inky blue or deep blue and name of the precipitate, or give reasons. Yes, when ammonium hydroxide is added to copper sulfate, first you get a pale blue precipitate and then the color changes to deep blue. Explain why. So you remember that some question on this is always asked. mark this as a 5-star question and very important. And in comparison to sodium hydroxide was insoluble, whereas ammonium hydroxide, it is soluble. So that is the difference which you are supposed to remember. So it's easier for you to remember by comparison. The next ion, that is lead and zinc, we'll consider and we'll discuss shortly. Thank you.